Let me introduce you to atmospheric aerosols. They are not from spray cans. They are small, solid particles floating in Earth's atmosphere. They come in different tastes. The bigger ones could be either dust from deserts, sea salt from ocean spray, or pollen from the flowers. The smaller ones are either ash from forest fires, or from combustion of engines, or sulfates from volcanic eruptions. Aerosols are also sorted according to their source as anthropogenic when are generated from human activities, and natural when are produced by the ecosystem. These aerosols are spread at the lower couple of kilometers of the atmosphere, but sometimes they are spread up to the stratosphere. Scientists have different methods to measure them. In situ approaches means that samples of air are collected and analyzed to estimate the aerosol composition and concentration. This is the most direct method, but only representative at the spot, either ground or aircraft. In situ, data is more useful to monitor local events like pollution. Remote sensing methods are used when the presence of the particles is measured from a distance. These approaches are best to estimate the total load of aerosols in the atmosphere. Main remote sensing approaches are divided to ground-based and satellite-based. In both of them, the sunlight is measured in order to estimate how much was decreased because of the particles. When measured from the ground, sun photometers are used by aiming at the sun. Ground data represent a local area but are more precise. Satellites are looking to Earth's surface and record the reflected sunlight. Satellites are giving a global perspective and are useful on monitoring large scales. In situ and remote sensing methods are not comparable in most cases since they focus on different areas. In HARMONIA Action, we focus on optical properties which are measured from sun photometers. The basic variables used to describe the aerosol state of the atmosphere are the following: aerosol optical depth, or AOD. How much sunlight is prevented from reaching the Earth's surface due to aerosols? This is estimated by the aerosol optical depth, or AOD. It is an indirect approach to understand how many aerosols are present in the whole atmosphere. The whole atmosphere means that AOD is representing the total effect on direct sunlight from aerosols at different heights. So, in most cases, it is not comparable with concentrations measured on the ground with in situ techniques. There are other factors that play a role in the amount of sunlight reaching the ground, such as clouds, trace gases, sun's position, and atmospheric scattering. These should be defined precisely to estimate AOD. Where there are very few aerosols, AOD is lower than 0.2, but in severe events that affect visibility, is more than 1. Angstrom exponent, or AE. AOD varies with wavelength of sunlight. This depends on the type of aerosol presented in the atmospheric column, defined by their molecular structure. So the spectral behavior of AOD is an indication for aerosol typing. This means that in lower visibility and UV regions, the extinction is higher. Bigger particles like dust and sea spray have angstrom exponent lower than 1, meaning that there is less difference of AOD throughout the spectrum. Small particles, usually anthropogenic ones, have higher values, meaning that their effect on sunlight is depending more on wavelength and affects more at UV region. Single scattering albedo, or SSA, defines the absorbing or scattering nature of the particles. This is a very important parameter because scattering of sunlight on aerosols causes the atmosphere to cool, but when the particles absorb the light, they cause warming. So, it is very critical to correctly estimate the single scattering albedo to understand the climate-related processes. scattering is symmetrical to all directions when there are small particles, but it becomes major in the forward directions as particles become bigger. The SSA is defined as the ratio of the decrease of sunlight due to scattering to the total decrease. When it is 1, there is only scattering, and lower values means more absorption. Generally, when it is more than 0.95, the atmosphere is cooled, and when it is less than 0.86, it is warmed. These are the ways we are studying atmospheric aerosols and their effects on sunlight. These approaches should be combined to understand aerosol dynamics. Climate models need this understanding to provide more accurate insights into the role of aerosols in climate change, paving the way for informed policy decisions and mitigation strategies.